Inductive voltage transformer or IVT is used in substation for measurement of voltage and protection purpose. In this video, we'll be going through all the parameters which will be mentioned on a nameplate of inductive voltage transformer or IVT of any voltage class. So to get the information of all the parameters, I'll recommend you to watch the video. Hello everyone, my name is Gaurav J. I post videos related to electrical engineering with easiest explanation on this channel. So if you are new here, consider subscribing the channel. Generally, IVTs you will find in 145 kV and below substation. Above 145 kV, CVTs are most commonly used. So let's understand the parameters that you will find on a nameplate of an IVT. So on top of the nameplate, you will find the name of the product, which is 132 kV inductive voltage transformer. It says rating plate and schematic diagram. Schematic diagram is on the right hand side. Similarly, on the nameplate of 33 kV IVT and 420 kV IVT. On the left hand side, type. Few manufacturers write the designation of the equipment or in simple language what manufacturer calls their product. Few manufacturers write it as outdoor oil field, like here on the 36 kV voltage transformer. So this indicates that the equipment is suitable for outdoor installation and it is filled with oil. SO number. This is an internal thing of manufacturer for their reference. Then year. This is the year of manufacturing. Next is spec, or this field also called as reference standard. This indicates the standard to which the equipment follows. In this case, it is mentioned as IS 3156. Now IS is Indian standard. This standard specifies the general requirement applicable for voltage transformers. If you see on the nameplate of 420 kV, specs or the reference standard is mentioned as IEC 60044-2. IEC is International Electrotechnical Commission. If you search this IEC on the official website of IEC, you'll find that this IEC is withdrawn and it is now replaced by IEC 61869-3. This IEC is for additional requirement for inductive voltage transformers. Latest IEC standard for IVT is IEC 61869-3. Then moving on, next is frequency, which is 50 Hz. Frequency could be different for different countries. Then IVT serial number. This is the serial number of IVT and it is mandatory to put on the nameplate as per the standards. Next, we have winding details of IVT. Refer to the first column. This tells us about the primary side of the transformer. First row in the first column tells us about the connection. So if you look at the schematic diagram, you will find letter A and N. A is basically our primary connection. In the second row, it says volts, which is mentioned as 132 kV by root 3. Now voltage transformers, we connect it across phase to earth and hence the voltage is divided by root 3. Burden and accuracy class is not applicable for primary winding. Then column 2, 3 and 4 tells us about the secondary winding. Let's first understand column 1 and winding 1. Winding 1 will be marked as 1A and 1N, which you can see on the schematic diagram. Then the secondary voltage is 110 volts by root 3. So this transformer is stepping down 132 kV by root 3 to 110 volts by root 3. 110 volt root 3 is the preferred secondary voltage value as per the IEC. Next is burden, which is mentioned as 200 VA. Let's understand what is burden. Circuit connected to the secondary winding is referred as burden. So in simple language, anything that you connect across the secondary winding is called as burden. So let's say this is our secondary winding and we need to connect a relay to it. Relay will have its internal resistance or impedance. Also, to connect the relay, we need connecting wires. These wires will also have some resistance. So resistance of wire plus resistance of relay will act as a burden of the secondary winding. For the first winding, rated burden is 200 VA. This indicates that you can connect up to 200 VA across this winding. It is not a good practice to specify higher burden than the required one, as this will increase the weight of IVT. Moving on, fourth row of secondary column, accuracy class. IVT has two types of accuracy class. One is protection and another is metering. In protection, we have two types as per IEC 61869-3, that is 3P and 6P. 3 or 6 in this class indicates the percentage of voltage error allowed, and letter P indicates the protection. Of course, 3P will be more accurate than 6P as the voltage error allowed is less as compared to 6P class, and hence it is the most commonly used class in IVTs. In metering, we have 0.1, 0.2, 0.5, 1.0 and 3.0. Again, this number indicates the percentage of voltage error allowed. So if secondary winding has the class of 0.2, then it indicates that only 0.2% error is allowed. And 0.2 class is also most commonly used class for measurement purpose in voltage transformers. Similarly, winding 2 is marked as 2A and 2N. It has secondary voltage of 110 volts by root 3, rated burden of 50 VA and accuracy class of 3P. Similarly, winding 3 is marked as 3P and 3N. It has secondary voltage of 110 volts by root 3, rated burden of 50 VA and accuracy class of 0.2. So total 2 protection windings and 1 metering winding. Moving on, higher system voltage or HSV is 145 kV. This is the voltage which can sustain in the system at any time and at any point. Then you may ask, what is 132 kV? Well, 132 kV is nominal system voltage or normal system voltage for which the system is designed. This is where most of the people get confused. 145 kV is higher system voltage and 132 kV is nominal or normal system voltage. Similarly, on the other nameplates, 36 kV is HSV and 33 kV is normal. 420 kV is HSV and 400 kV is normal. Next is insulation levels. These are the highest system voltages used to check the insulation properties of the equipment. It can also be called as insulation levels if combined. Here you will see two values. First is 275 kV RMS, which is power frequency voltage, and another is lightning impulse voltage, which is mentioned as 650 kV peak. Power frequency withstand voltage can be caused by these reasons: phase to earth faults, load rejection, ferroresonance and Ferranti effects. And hence equipment shall withstand power frequency voltage caused by these reasons. Insulation levels are defined by IEC. So for example, for 145 kV, the power frequency voltage defined by IEC is 275 kV RMS. Lightning impulse voltage is generally generated due to lightning strokes. And of course, equipment has to withstand these voltages too. For this also, IEC has defined the values based on the experience and studies made. For 145 kV voltage level, lightning impulse voltage defined by IEC is 650 kV peak. There is one more type of insulation level, which is called as switching impulse voltage. Switching over voltages is generally occurs above 245 kV, and hence on the nameplate of 420 kV IVT, you will find the third value as well, that is 1050 kV peak. The next is voltage factor. As you can see on the nameplate, it is mentioned as 1.2 continuous and 1.5 for 30 seconds. So what is voltage factor? 1.2 continuous means the IVT is capable of taking 132 kV by root 3 multiply by 1.2, that is 91.45 kV voltage continuously. In normal condition, only 132 kV by root 3, that is approximately 76 kV, will flow. But the IVT is capable of taking 91.45 kV continuously. 1.5 for 30 seconds means the IVT is capable of taking 132 kV by root 3 multiplied by 1.5, that is 114.3 kV for 30 seconds. Voltage factor is important in case if the system is going through abnormal conditions which may cause hike in voltage or voltage swell. Next is creepage distance. Creepage distance is nothing but the shortest distance between the two conducting parts. There are two types of creepage distance used, that is 25 mm per kV and 31 mm per kV. 25 mm per kV creepage distance is used majorly. 31 mm per kV creepage distance is used where there is a high pollution like cement industries. So if you multiply 145 kV by 25, you'll get 3625 mm, which is mentioned on our nameplate. Then the total weight of IVT in kgs. Next is total volume of oil which is used in this IVT as an insulating medium in liters. Now, two important parameters are missing on this nameplate, that is thermal burden and simultaneous burden, which we can see on this nameplate. Let's understand what are these parameters, starting with thermal burden. This indicates the total amount of apparent power we can take from IVT at a same time without increasing the temperature of IVT as specified by IEC. On the nameplate, it is mentioned as 300 VA, which indicate we can take up to 300 VA power and still the temperature of IVT will remain within the limits as specified by IEC. The next is simultaneous burden. This indicates how much apparent power we can take at the same time from all the provided windings without affecting the accuracy of metering core, that is 0.2 class. Secondary winding of voltage transformer is generally connected on a same core and hence the burden connected on the one winding may affect the accuracy of other winding. And hence it is specified that how much amount of total VA burden you can connect on all the windings of CVT without affecting the accuracy of 0.2 class or any other class. On our nameplate, it is mentioned as 100 VA and 0.2 class, which means we can connect total 100 VA on all the windings put together and still get the accuracy of 0.2 class. If you see on the bottom of the nameplate, one caution is mentioned as LV or low voltage terminal should not be short circuited. Now why so? I'll ask you to let us know the reason behind this via comments. So that's all for this video guys. I hope you can now identify the different parameters that you will find on a nameplate of IVT of any voltage class. If you like the video, do hit the like button and share it with your friends as well. Also do check out the description of this video as I have mentioned some of the other videos which you may like. That's all for this video guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.